tree to drop. Here is a strange and bitter cry.
And that was Strange Fruit by Billie Holiday. Up next, we have Margaret Stanton reporting from Maycomb, Alabama, on the pending trial of Negro Tom Robinson. Take it away, Margaret.
Hello, this is Margaret Stanton reporting from Maycomb County. Today, I have the chance to interview some of the key figures in the pending trial of Tom Robinson. I have been graciously given time with defense attorney Atticus Finch, the father of the victim, Bob Ewell, and the victim herself, Mayella Ewell. First, I will be speaking to Bob and Mayella Ewell. Thank you for taking the time to speak with us today. Mayella, what can you tell us about the defendant, Tom Robinson?
Well, the night of November 21, I was coming in from the woods with a load of kindling. And just as I got to the fence, I heard Mayella screaming like a stuck hog inside the house. Well, Mayella was raising this holy racket, so I dropped my load and run as fast as I could, but I run into the fence. But when I got disentangled, I run up to the window and I seen that black nigger running on my Mayella.
All right. Thank you for enlightening our audience, Mr. Ewell. As important as that is, can you tell me anything else about the defendant?
That Tom Robinson lived down yonder that nigger nest. Past the house every day. I've asked the county for 15 years to clean out that nest down yonder. They're dangerous to live around.
I see. Miss Mayella, is there anything else you would like to tell our audience about the case?
My Mayella's been through a lot, you hear? You don't gotta tell them nothing if you don't wanna.
We would really appreciate your side of the story, Miss Mayella.
I got one thing to say, and then I ain't gonna say no more. That nigger yonder took advantage of me, and if you fine fancy people don't want to do nothing about it, then you're all yellow stinking cowards. Stinking cowards, the lot of you. Your fancy airs don't come to nothing. Your mammon and Miss Mayellerin don't come to nothing.
I would have liked to thank the Ewells for their time on our show, but it appears I ran out of time in their favor. Moving on, we'll hear from Atticus Finch, the lawyer defending Tom Robinson in court. Thank you for your time, Mr. Finch. I know you're a very busy man. From what I've been hearing, the popular opinion here in Maycomb is that Tom Robinson is guilty of the crime against Mayella Ewell. What is your opinion on the matter?
They're certainly entitled to think that, and they're entitled to full respect for their opinions, but before I can live with other folks, I've got to live with myself. The one thing that doesn't abide by majority rule is a person's conscience.
That is very refreshing, Mr. Finch. Can you shed some light on the potential for impartiality of the justice system in this case?
Well, I'm no idealist to believe firmly in the integrity of our courts and in the jury system. That is no ideal to me. It is a living, working reality. A court is no better than each man sitting on this jury. A court is only as sound as its jury, and a jury is only as sound as the men who make it up.
So, did your distrust of the jury system lead you into defending Tom Robinson? Or was there something else that prompted you to make that leap?
The one place where a man ought to get a square deal is in the courtroom, be he any color of the rainbow. But people have a way of carrying their resentments right into a jury box. But there is one way in this country in which all men are created equal. There is one human institution that makes a pauper the equal of a Rockefeller, the stupid man the equal of an Einstein, and the ignorant man the equal of any college president. That institution is a court. It can be the Supreme Court of the United States or the humblest J.P. court in the land, or this honorable court in which this jury serves. Our courts have their faults, as does any human institution, but in this country our courts are the great levelers, and in our courts all men are created equal.
Thank you for your valuable insight, Mr. Finch. I wish you the best of luck in your defense. I pray the justice system will truly be blind someday to all manners of physical difference. This has been Margaret Stanton reporting on the pending trial.
There we have it, folks, the most up-to-date coverage of the Negro Tom Robinson's trial. Maybe this will give y'all something to think about before the trial officially starts tomorrow. Don't forget to tune in tonight for FDR's Fireside Chat. To take us away for the night, we have Fats Waller with It's a Sin to Tell a Lie. Thank you and good night.
Thank you. land.